What's crack? Look, you guys.
Your girl is back.
Welcome back to my channel, guys. Did you miss me? Did you miss me?
I know y'all did. And I've been slacking. Came back looking like somebody's bougie rich auntie. As always, there's mommy in the back. Mom, say hi. Please, you see?
Just
want to talk to my parents. Chill. Anyway, I just want to come back and give you a little life update. So, obviously, it's a new year. We are 15 days into the new year. Have you all been sticking with those New Year's resolutions, or did you all give up on the second day? Yes or no? Because we're not doing that this year. We have to stay consistent. So come on now, you better get back into it or stay focused. But anyway, I've just been working, so I barely have time to eat, think, breathe or sleep. So that's why I haven't been talking to y'all or catching up with y'all. I know the last time I posted a video was like 2 weeks ago, but yeah, it's also because the one video that I did record didn't wanna download in my editing app, so just like so that's why I didn't end up posting that. I've been on my green juice journey, and guys, let me tell you, that thing tastes nasty, but it's an acquired taste, so you get used to it, and I'm starting to enjoy it, kinda sorta. Yeah, the lady that I take care of moved, so every day has just been jam-packed. I haven't been able to record anything, and I'm listening to my grandpa and not recording while driving. So that's another reason why I haven't been able to, like, check in with y'all and stuff. We're fasting. I started on New Year's Day. So we don't eat all day, and then in the evening, we eat normal food. Well, not really normal food, but a healthier version of what we'd usually eat. Only because we're fasting in winter, and in South Africa, we usually fast in summer. And it's easier to fast in summer, according to my mother, because you don't get as hungry, you're more thirsty. So,
and
yeah.
Please explain to them what fasting means, because people have their own notions of what fasting means. They don't know the absolute correct definition. We do not fast like religions that say they fasting means that they're eating the whole day and they're just not eating certain things. Fasting in the dictionary means abstaining from food. So when you wake up, you do not eat, you drink water. You drink water the whole day and you break your fast at 5 or whatever time after 5. But there's no business of saying I'm fasting, but I'm only eating vegetables in the day. That is not fasting, that is eating. Any fool can do that.
Okay, so you tell me to explain and then you do the whole
explanation. Yeah, because now they...
So anyway, my mother gave you all the little explanation, and you could hear the aggressiveness in her voice, because yes, she takes this very seriously. But anyway, yeah, we don't eat whole day from the morning up until 5 o'clock in the evening or 6 o'clock, depending on what time I get home. That's when we will break our fast, and then yeah, the cycle just repeats. So we're doing that for 21 days, and it's been easier, I think, because it didn't get forced on me, because I made the decision on my own to say that I'm gonna fast this year. But if somebody had to tell me, oh, we're starting the fast on this day, chill, I would have been starving every day from the time I wake up until I go to sleep. So I'm glad that I made that decision. And we also usually do it from like the first week of January, not New Year's weekend or whatever. We usually do it a little bit later, and then it goes all the way through to my birthday. My birthday is the 26th of January. This year I was like, we're not doing that for my birthday. So that's why I started on the first day. My mother started on the second. So I'll finish on the 21st and she'll finish on the 22nd. But yeah, and then we got birthday plans, so that'll be another vlog.
Yes, and 2023 is the year of being healthy and happy in everything you do. Don't let anybody or anything get you down. The minute you feel sad or feel upset about what somebody else said or did to you, just remember, you're God's child. You don't need validation from anybody else.
Period. Ooh, ooh, ooh. And she's left the building. Yeah. So, hold on. So, yeah. And then, yeah, I got things planned for my birthday. And then my mother's birthday is like the week after. Her birthday is the 8th of February. So, we're also going to do something for her birthday. And then, I'm also just going to try to get out more. I'm going to start going to young adults group at our church. So that I can start meeting people and making friends. Because, guys, I need positive people in my life. I can't be having negativity around me or anything. Because I'm trying to flourish. I'm trying to grow. I'm trying to, you know, make progress and get better. I'm not trying to stay in the same place and let negativity bring me down. You know what I'm saying? Because I know God is using me and he can use others around me, but they have to allow him to use them in order for them to fulfill his plan. You know, because everything that we do has to bring him glory. So if it's not bringing him glory, he's obviously gonna take it away or just remove it, period. So yeah, and yeah, I just want to get out more and meet people because I'm not really a club girl anymore. When I was 18, yeah, from 18 to like 21, I enjoyed going to the club. Now I'm on to bigger and better things. I wanna travel more. I wanna explore like cities more. I wanna go out to try new restaurants. I wanna have meaningful conversations. I don't just want surface level things in my life. So if I don't want that and I'm not gonna accept that, then I need to stop associating myself with people that are just there, you know. And I don't mean that in a bad way or to offend anybody, but yeah, I just need change. I like change. Change is inevitable and change is what helps you grow as a person. So I need to heal and change it internally and externally. Because when you're feeling good on the inside, it'll show on the outside. So, I just need to, you know, step it up a notch. And also, I have so many plans and so many goals that I want to achieve throughout this year. And, yeah, by having negative people around you or people that's going to bring you down, that's going to just pull the brake on all of your progress that you're making, you know. So yeah, and then also when you surround yourself by people that are like-minded or that are trying to level up and progress and make money and, you know, do the things that need to be done, then you start attracting that. When you continue to stay in the same cycle of complaining and saying, oh, I don't have money or oh this or that, then you sit in your ways or stay stuck in your brain. Everything goes with your thoughts. Your thoughts are a very powerful thing as well as your tongue. So whatever you think and whatever you speak, you bringing it to life. So the more positive you think and the more positive things that you talk about, the more positive what am I trying to say? Because I'm preaching. The more positive things will start happening in your life and the more good things will attract to you or come to you compared to the bad things, you know. And then I know I never ever talk about this. I'm sure you're must be wondering, I wonder if Kaitlyn got a boyfriend, I wonder if she's seeing anybody. Guys, I don't talk about that because that's also a whole process. Especially in this country. It's truly something. But I'm just taking time with myself, learning myself more and more, and also correcting past mistakes that I didn't really think was a mistake. But now that I look back at it, I'm like, man, you attract the same person just in different bodies. And we're not trying to do that because I want healthy love, and one day I want my children to be able to say, I can see that my father loves my mother, and I can see that my mother loves my father. You know, like vice versa. It must show in our relationship how much we love each other. Because if anything, communication is key, and also just respecting each other, having healthy boundaries with your friends, your family, your partner, and also just loving people all around, whether it's platonic or whether it's relationship, like with a partner. Just loving people the way that they want to be loved, because we know how to love somebody the way that we were taught how to love, or the way that we think they want to be loved. But sometimes that's not always the case, and we end up in situations where we're giving more than we're receiving, or people are just using us and they're just taking from us, you know. So it needs to be reciprocated, and it needs to be understood by both people, like, okay, this is how I want to be loved and how I receive love, versus how you give off love, and this is how you want to be loved and how you want to receive love, versus how you want me to love you, you know. So yeah. And what else did I want to tell you all about? Just trying new things, guys. I want to try new things and just step out of my comfort zone. I'm also very honest and straightforward, but I feel like I've been in a shell, so instead of talking about how I feel, I just like close off, and then I like isolate myself and I process my thoughts on my own, and I just, when I see the issue, I resolve it. But I'm not gonna, I don't fight, I don't argue. So if we're having a conversation and we're trying to rush something out, we are not about to argue. We are about to do it in a healthy way, because if you're gonna argue, go argue with yourself, because I'm not gonna argue with you. Go get somebody else to do it. So there's that too. But yeah, I really miss my friends and family. Well, I have like this much friends at home. Everybody else is acquaintances, because moving to another country shows you why people were really in your life, and it reveals that a lot of the times people are there because it's beneficial and because it's convenient, because you're around, because you're there, you know, versus when you move away and you see, okay, I understand people have busy lives, don't get me wrong, I'm not saying people must message me 24/7 like, how are you, Katie, what you doing, da-da-da, you know, unnecessary conversation, or just check in every now and again, that's fine. And I know that your life has moved on and my life has also gone on, so there's nothing that I can do. But I miss this amount of people, my friends that I do still have back home. And then I miss my family so much. So much. Let me not get emotional. But I really do miss them. And my plan is to eventually bring them here, whether they want to move here or whether they just want to visit. But I just need my family. I'm not about to cry on here. Yeah, I gathered myself. Because I haven't seen them in such a long time. And it's hard seeing everything just happen from a distance, because you can't just go back and forth. Hold on. Yeah, life, as I was still saying, life goes on. My babies have grown so much. But I was there on the phone from the time they were born up until this point. And it makes me so happy that they know who I am and they get to see me. They get to talk to me, you know. But yo, if we didn't have phones like this, I don't know what I would have done here. And I'm so grateful to have my mother and my aunties that are here. I have a cousin that's also in America, but she doesn't stay as close by, so I don't get to see her as often as I would like. And then I have friends that are everywhere. So yeah, it's something. It's truly something. So yeah, another thing. Guys, if you know anybody who wants to do up here, tell them that I do consultations, because time is money. And as you can see, I told you at the beginning that I don't really have a lot of time. So if they want to find out about the up here process and all of that, I charge $100 an hour, because I don't pay about my time, as I said. So yeah, they can get more information from me, because I know people always come to me and want to know about the process and all of that. So that's the easiest way to get it done. And then, yeah, guys, I just want you to be great this year. Do the things that need to be done. Kill it. And we're in this together. This YouTube thing, y'all are my family also. So I love y'all so much. And you don't even understand it. That's why I get so sad when I can't record and can't do stuff. Because, you know, like, dang, I miss my little nuggets. That's what I think I'm going to call y'all. So, yeah. And... Also, oh my goodness, guess what? I'll give you a second. We reached 10,000 views, not just on one video, like all in all. From, because I've had this YouTube channel for a year now, I think. Yeah, just over a year. And the other day when I woke up and I was getting ready for work, I usually check my emails in the morning and all of that. And when I went into my email, I saw congratulations on 10,000 views. I was like, oh my goodness, thank you so much. Guys, that's baby steps. Oh, excuse me. And I'm so far. I'm so proud of how far we've come. And I'm so excited for what's yet to come. Because this is only the beginning. This is the baby stages. You know, it's still a little tiny pickaninny. So... it's gonna get bigger and bigger and bigger, and I just hope and pray. I know God's with me, so I hope that I touch people through my videos, and I hope that when people look at me, they see Him working in me and see Him working through me to make you all happy. Because if it wasn't for Him, then I wouldn't be able to have the impact that I do or be able to do the things that need to be done. So thank you, Jesus. Yeah, I'm just so proud of us, guys. But this is just a little life update, little check-in. I know I went off on different topics and stuff, but I just wanted to give you all a little something, you know, a little, so that you'll have something. But don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Tell a friend to tell a friend, because if you don't want us, you don't want. And don't forget to turn the bell and like a ding dong. I love you guys. We will be back for now. This is all that I have to give, but we will be back with some bangers. And just stay tuned. I love you. Peace.
Could you catch my vibe if I could match your style? I see you playing.